Am I a real woman?
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 I think there's really no such thing as a real male or female. That's just my opinion. But I mean, masculinity and femininity, it's something you learn socially. It's not a biological process. But I guess every female has like their own set of characteristics, and that goes the same thing for guys. And you know, having a definition means like setting some sort of standard, and that means like finding some sort of rules.
What makes a real male? I think that he's mature, and that he could provide for himself, and he's good to his mother, and respects women. Honestly, I'm not lying.
That you don't have to be macho. It's not about being tough.
I don't know. I think there's no such thing as a real female or male. I think it's whoever you want to be.
Females is emotional. You know what I mean? Men don't really deal with their emotions too much. They hold it in.
Well, like a real woman shouldn't be measured on like, well, there are a lot of different factors that would make up a woman, like her character or personality. But like, looks are only part of what you would look for in a woman. So it's not like looks are what is the most important.
Women are terrific. Women are really good and they have great friends, and they have great relationships with their friends, and they confide a lot, and we use our friends to help support us when we have problems. And I think we just have a great network.
A person who thinks, who laughs, who jokes, who sits like a lady, who stands like a lady, who talks like a lady.
It's about the person. It's about what they're doing. You know, if they're, you know, interested in life, interested in educating themselves, interested in, you know, having a career and being good to their, you know, family and everything else like that.
Basically, to be a real woman, you have to know what you want and be willing to do what you have to do to get that.
Dear editors of whatever magazine I see in the nearest grocery that's usually meant for females, I would like to ask you to please stop making half the female population feel like they have to wear makeup and throwing into a craze of beauty products. And I want you to express how people truly look, not show these thin models that most of us will never be and who are very unhealthy, and just general show real women how they are in life. Thank you.
Do you think a female needs makeup not only to enhance herself but make herself feel like a real woman? Do you think that's needed?
No, you don't need to have makeup to to feel like a real woman, because you could do whatever you want, and if that makes you happy, that's all that matters.
Okay, so basically, do you think a real woman should walk around with makeup and be fake and wear tight clothes?
Well, that's one's opinion.
Well, what's your opinion?
That's everyone is their own person. You choose what you choose to do, you know what I mean? Some people choose to put makeup on, some people don't.
Well, I guess it's a traditional thing that's been going on for many centuries, and it's definitely something that's ingrained in our society for beauty magazines and movies and everything. Since girls are little, they're taught to, you know, play with dolls and make them look beautiful and brush their hair. So
right,
yeah,
right.
I just think it's something that, you know, it's began long ago, and it's so ingrained in our society now.
I don't feel that they have to wear makeup. I feel that natural beauty is their beauty. You know, the way God made you is the way you present yourself. That's how I feel.
All right. I would like to know why, when I look in the video, there's always light-skinned chicks instead of dark-skinned chicks.
Why do you think you have to be light-skinned to be in a cover of a magazine?
I guess that has to do with, like, the media, basically. Because, like, America is still predominantly white people, and the media is controlled by predominantly white people. That's why you see light-skinned people, the majority of them. And I guess that's one of the really main reasons why white is like beautiful, and why white is like superior, and why white had like more privileges.
I've seen more light-skinned than dark-skinned people on cover magazines.
Why do you think so?
Because they say white skin attracts more audience members.
I've seen like both. I don't think it really matters to whether you have light skin or dark skin to be on a magazine. It's like more about like how the public views you.
I'd like to say something to the toy makers Mattel. I would like to ask them, why do they feel the need to put white Barbies in the front all the time, and the black Barbies and the Spanish Barbies are always on the sidelines, and you know, where are the Asian Barbie dolls? And the second thing, I like to tell them that women come in all sizes, so why is Barbie always this thin?
Why when you have like big people in real life, you make them look smaller in magazines and stuff, instead of being their own person?
The models of the world who have about a size minus two, and it's kind of a shame. It's kind of a shame what American society, or the ideal that's given out as the society that kind of looks like, you know, a stick figure, is very sad. And I don't think it has anything to do with what women really look like or really should look like.
Change their look, become a model, for example, change their hair, makeup, weight less, clothing.
Well, I would only lose weight for health reasons and things like that. But other than that, I think I'm fine in the size that I am. And like Dove has a campaign now, and that like someone like me could be a model, someone like you could be a model, any size could be a model. It's not, I don't know. It's not about like what size you are.
I think, you know, women come in all different shapes and sizes and different, obviously, skin types and hair types. You know, I disagree with pushing a certain ideal of a woman.
I would like to say to all the video producers, you need to stop making women look like hoes and like they have no education and no sense and are just hoeing for money.
I just want to know why you can't put more clothes on women and to stop degrading them in videos. Girl, you know what we came here for, was you a temp child. We need a temp child. I
said, now come on, girl, you know what we came here for, we need a temp child. There's nothing wrong with choreography, but because they get paid for it, and that's a choice. It's not like they're getting demanded to do it. But, I mean, it's not good for, like, the younger age. But, you know, if they're going to try to make a living doing it, and I don't really see nothing wrong with it, because it's only choreography anyway.
With rap, they usually have no respect for women. Other music videos, they try to show respect, because it depends on who the rapper is. Rap music, they just usually have no respect. Country music, stuff like that, they just usually focus on the music and the songs.
Well, like women in music videos, they're usually like in these skimpy like apparel, and it's just basically for sex appeal to like the public, and it's not very respectful to them, but it's just for the audiences like that.
I think sex sells, and like I guess that's how they make their money. So I mean, not everybody's like subject to watch it or anything.
All right, so if that was your little sister or your girlfriend in a video shaking their ass, or the magazines half butt naked, would you accept it?
No.
Why not? They making money, like you said, sex sells.
It depends if like that's what they really want to do, and like they're just dancing or whatever. Not like if they're doing something explicit like on BET Uncut or anything, then I guess I can understand it.
As long as it ain't no porno, it's all good. As long as it's not a porno. If you're doing choreography, if you want to dance, you know, do your thing.
So you think shaking your ass in a video is choreography? I'm trying to say.
But they don't really be doing that, because if you look, they be doing steps.
All right, so steps. One, two steps, shake their ass. One, two steps, shake their ass is mostly what you get.
I mean, nobody complain when Beyonce do it.
was told I was beautiful, but what does that mean to you? Look into the mirror, who's inside there? The one with the long hair, same old me again today.